Hi, I'm DJ Mike, and right now I'm in Hong Kong with the lovely, talented Avril Lavigne. Hi.
Yeah, hi.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Excellent, very well, thank you. Oh, let's start with the questions. All right, how do you feel about being back in Asia, this time with your new album?
I love Asia. It's a place that I always come to on tour. The fans here are amazing, and I feel so lucky to, you know, I'm from Canada.
Sure.
To be able to come across the world and to be here and have my music being played and heard.
Definitely. You have tons of fans in Asia. Definitely.
Yeah, it's cool.
Okay. Well, how is your new album, Goodbye Lullaby, different from your previous album?
Say, other than the first single, What the Hell, it is a less pop rock album.
Okay.
It's a little more mellow, kind of more organic and stripped down, and it's not like it's too different from anything I've done. It's still very new, but it has a different approach and feel throughout it. It's a more emotional, kind of deeper record, but it's positive.
Positive. You said that this album would be a little more personal?
All my albums are personal. This is personal on a different level. Like,
yeah. Okay. But speaking of this album, what is your favorite track on the whole album? I know it's hard to decide, right?
Yeah, no, not for me. The song called Goodbye that I wrote and I produced.
Goodbye, brown eyes.
And so that was my first time producing on this record.
Oh.
And it's a song that is probably the most emotional song that I've ever written, even recorded. So I don't know if I'll even play that one live, but that meaningful to me.
Sure. I mean,
and it also inspired the album title Goodbye Lullaby.
Okay. In what way?
Well, because the song Goodbye means so much to me, and it was just one of the songs that naturally stood out on the record.
Sure.
I just thought of Goodbye Lullaby, and it's like saying goodbye, but it's not a bad thing or a negative thing. It's a lullaby represents something positive and sweet and soothing and comforting. So it's kind of like, even though, you know, there is a goodbye, it's not a bad one.
Sure. And you got to sort of produce it as well, so it's extra personal as well, right? What is your next single from the album after What the Hell? Would it be that song?
Sure. I don't think Goodbye will be a single.
Okay.
Because it's like really raw.
Okay.
Maybe, let's say that one. Maybe my song Push.
Okay.
Which is my other favorite one.
Okay, great. Why that single?
Well, I think that it's just a song that feels good and it has like a cool vibe and it's catchy and it's like a strong lyric.
Okay. Excellent. Well, speaking of your plans though, where do you see yourself in 10 years? I mean, you've already have so much life experience under your belt already. Where do you see yourself in the future?
So I'm 26 now.
Yeah.
I'm 36.
I'm the same age as well, so
you are?
Yeah, that's just blowing my mind right now, 36, but.
I would hope to still be rocking out and doing music, and I would hope to have done a couple movies and kind of just take everything to the next level as far as my fashion line, Abidon, and my foundation that I've just started, the Avril Lavigne Foundation. So everything that I do today, like my heart and soul is in it, and I, you know, I just want to keep doing it, working really hard, raising the bar.
That's very cool. So, I mean, because you've of course expanded a bunch. You're doing movies, of course, your music, your fragrance, Abidon, your clothing line. So what's next? Besides, you did your foundation, philanthropy.
What's next, really? It's just working really hard and doing a world tour this year.
Okay. Great. So more tours in the future, hopefully?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, great.
Pretty please, I love the train.
So what is the average day like for Avril Lavigne? All right, you get up in the morning, what's the first thing you do? Skateboard in your garage? The Wall Street Journal, what do you do?
When I'm at home and I'm not working?
Yeah, when you're at home.
Yeah, I like to wake up and do some form of exercise. I like, when I have my friends over, sometimes we grab skateboards and go. I live in a gated community, which is really nice because then I don't get followed by paparazzi and stuff like that.
So I could see that being
like
an issue.
I can walk out in my sweats and skateboard.
Sure.
Sometimes we do that. I have like electric scooters, and we go. There's like
nice.
Yeah, it's kind of cool. So, I like to bike ride. I like to surf a little. I don't know. terrified of the water.
But you have a very active lifestyle.
Yeah, apparently. I like the outdoors a lot. I like camping and boating.
Nice. Wow. Oh, what is the most important thing that you've learned about the music business after being in it for about 10 years already?
I think it's just really important to do what you like, and when you're an artist, to make sure that, you know, you believe in the songs and that your heart is there. And if you have to work very hard in this industry, I know that I certainly have. Mm-hmm. And if you be really dedicated, it kind of changes your whole life, so you have to really be there in your heart.
Speaking of which, like, you seem like a person who's very clings to her roots. So I have to ask you, what do you miss the most when you're touring? Because you tour all over the world. You're away from home. What do you miss the most?
Kitchen.
Your kitchen. You like to cook?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? What's your special dish?
I have fun, like, with preparing dinner and, like, I like silver and, like, fancy little platters and putting candles on and stuff like that. And drinking red wine. It's relaxing and it's fun to cook. My mom cooked a lot when we were growing
Very
up.
Cool.
So I learned a lot from her, and I guess it kind of reminds me of being at home with her.
Oh, very cool. What's your special dish? You have to have one.
Well, I make everything from, I like to eat healthy, but when I cook, I cook bad, so I'll make like homemade ravioli and pasta and bruschetta and like all that stuff. And
that Yorkshire, doesn't sound bad.
Yorkshire pudding dinner. Well, I kind of believe in eating more like vegetables and salads,
and I make
homemade soup, so I can make everything.
Okay, sure, great. Well, maybe, you ever make it on tour?
Sometimes on my tour bus, I cook,
Very nice.
But I cut hair on tour.
Okay, really?
My band
multi-talented.
Pretty much all gotten mohawks.
Really? Wow, multi-talented. It's Avril Lavigne right here. All right.